After cutting the call, Jungkook went to the bedroom but didn't find her there. He roamed the whole mansion and finally found her, but he didn't go near her as she was too busy talking. Jungkook saw her talking closely with Jimin, which he didn't like, and he even got jealous. His fist tightened. Then Jimin saw Jungkook standing at a distance away from them. Jimin stood up alertly. Following Jimin's gaze, she also looked back and found Jungkook looking at her parents again. "Come with me," she swallowed, seeing his eyes and the way he was looking at her like he was going to eat her. Then Jimin noticed her fear and came between them, saying something. "Jungkook, is there a problem?" "Yes, she is the problem," he said, not taking his eyes off her. "Didn't you hear? Come with me." He was coming near one, but Jimin interrupted Jungkook's angry expression and stopped him with a conscious look. "Bro, you're angry. It's because of a stupid father," Jungkook said, looking at Wan as if he wanted to jerk away from Jimin. But Jimin held Jungkook's wrist strongly while Wan nervously crushed her dress. "Please come with me," he said, dragging Jungkook along. "It's not that easy to make Jungkook listen, but Jimin can easily make him listen if he thinks about it," she sighed in relief. "Oh, Jungkook, of course, any father can hear their voice. Calm your anger. Jimin, why are you defending him? Even after listening to it?" "See, I'm not defending him, but explaining to you that there is a reason behind his actions." "Leave it. What were we both talking about?" "With why?" Jungkook blinked his eyes with a cold face. "Actually, she was crying, wiping her lips harshly when I ran to her. I asked her what happened, but she didn't say anything. I really felt sad, like she was my girl." "Can you please stop it?" Jimin was confused by Jungkook's sudden interruption. Wasn't he the one who asked about what they were talking about with her? "What?" "Nothing." Saying this, he immediately left. What happened to him suddenly? He didn't even listen to the whole matter. He is behaving strangely these days. I was rubbing my wet hair, seeing my reflection in the mirror. My gaze fell on my lips. There was no mark of any color. It's been 3 days since I saw Jungkook's face. These 3 days have been at least good for me, and Jimin has become closer to me. As I was thinking, I remembered my grandma's words. She used to tell me that my future husband would take care of me like a baby and would take me wherever I want. Jimin is almost like what my grandma describes to me. And this Jungkook, oh my god, he's the opposite. A demon I never imagined in my dream. I miss my family too. While she was wiping her wet hair, talking to herself in her mind, she saw the bedroom door open loudly and saw Jungkook, who was done and his appearance was totally mess. His shirt was unruly and his long hair was messy. She turned around to face him, and when his dark eyes caught her figure, he wiped his sweat with the back of his hand and smirked. "Oh, you're here, baby." He was coming towards her, smirking. She was gripping the towel tightly, feeling tense as she guessed he was drunk. "I miss you so much, baby," he said, looking down at her. She felt uncomfortable with his gaze. "What you looking at?" When she asked him that, he raised his head and took some steps closer to her. He reached out and grabbed her chin, forcing her to look into his eyes. "I was looking at what belongs to me." As he was talking, she felt more disgusted, especially as she smelled his thumbiness. She wanted to pull on him, but his grip on her chin tightened. He chuckled, sensing her disgust. "Don't you like drinking, boys?" Jungkook chuckled darkly and immediately released her chin. She thought maybe he was leaving, but his hand trailed down her neck before resting on her shoulders. He smirked darkly and squeezed her shoulders. "Jungkook, stop touching." Oh, this is the second time you have called by my name, isn't it? Groaned and leaned against her ear. I am going crazy already, baby. Don't tease me anymore. Saying this, he slowly brushed his lips against her neck, but she pushed him back. Stop it, Jungkook. What if I won't? I'll call Jimin. Oh, you are just my little plaything after all. You aren't worth much on Jimin's own, but with me. Not even complete finished, he pushed her onto the bed. She tried to back away, but he grabbed her ankle, pulling her back down. Not so fast, baby girl. Let's have some fun. He climbed on top of her, pinning her wrist and leaving a kiss on her neck. She was in tears, asking him to stop, but he wasn't listening to her. As he kissed her and left a kiss on her forehead, she wasn't able to stop him because her wrist was captured by his grip. However, she kicked him in the face, which made him release his grip on her. He fell to the other side of the bed, groaning. She immediately got up, about to run in fear, but she bumped into Jimin as he also entered hurriedly upon hearing their screams. What's going on here? He was in disbelief, but point hugged him crying. Jimin didn't understand anything, but he saw Jungkook groaning and holding his private part, sitting up straight, while she was hugging and crying. He tried to force himself on me, and when I tried to stop him, I kicked him. What? Please help me. He is very dangerous. I don't want to stay here. Let me go home to my dad. Crying, hugging him tightly in fear. Jungkook, how could you force her? She means nothing to me. Our enemy is Mr. Kim, not his daughter. I accidentally tried to do it. Not on purpose, Jimin. I was drunk. It's not that easy to say you are drunk. You could have hurt her by any chance. Jimin, if I tried, she can fight back. She is stubborn, and you saw that. She kicked me. Her daring, her beauty, whatever she was doing, is driving me crazy. I want her. If you want her, then put it in the effort to win her humanly, not by force. Leave it about me. And Jimin, I also have been observing. Why are you so close with her? What manner of question is that, Jungkook? Leave it. Jungkook was angry. Jungkook, you are hiding something, aren't you? Jungkook heard it but didn't answer as he was leaving. Hey, Bajudev, didn't you say you wouldn't leave me alone? She murmured, but she noticed footsteps approaching the room. She turned back and saw Jungkook. She felt nervous, but she didn't show it. When I'll marry you? What sudden change in you? I'm not just boring you, but a slut. And slay here to you. Look, I'm serious. I'll marry you. I won't marry a guy like you. Never. You disrespect my family and me. You tried to force me. You hurt me physically. And you are starting a new drama about marriage? He got unnerved by the way she was describing him. He passed a glass table behind him, making his hand bleed. He showed it to her, said sincerely, "See, I never wanted to marry anyone in my life. You are the first woman I have been stuck on and can't move on from. I love you. Damn it, even if you are against me, even when you look at me with hatred, I love you. I have become obsessed with you. I can't even stay calm. If I can't see your face, I want you, but not this way. I want you as my wife. I'm sorry for everything. I have said because I have been feeling guilty since last night." She was shocked by his explanation, but she gathered even more courage and approached him willingly. She looked at his bleeding hand and studied his face, noticing his expression, but he seemed commanding and urgent. "Did you forget what I said to you, Jungkook? I won't forgive you for this, not just for this, but for everything. I'll make you regret it. I'll make you kneel before me." "Then you mocked me, saying I won't lower my head for you, baby girl." He shut his eyes, suppressing himself with getting more as he knelt down even lower, bowing his head and stunning her in surprise. "Please forgive me, Bonnie. I'm scared now because I don't want to lose you. I want you. Please, I love you." She didn't say anything as he waited for her forgiveness, but suddenly gunfiring sounds started near the mansion. He immediately got up and she flinched as the glass window started shuddering while bullets tore through the room. "Rival gangs have started firing," he said as he looked around and grabbed her hand. Two guards came in hurriedly. "Boss, Mr. Kim started firing suddenly." Quan was surprised, but Jungkook looked confused rather than shocked. "How could he come in? By passing our security? This shouldn't have happened." "He didn't come alone. He brought another enemy gang with him. Jimin boss is downstairs fighting with their team. Please come downstairs, boss. First you both stay here and protect her. I'll handle them." The guards nodded. Jungkook took the gun from his waistband and ran downstairs daringly. "My dad, Kim, I'll go to." The guards held her wrist. "No, ma'am, it's too dangerous. Please, please don't go." "No, I'll go." She tried to release her hands from the grip. In the living room, splashed with blood from both sides of the teams. Mr. Kim's team and John's team were firing, and many were dying from bullet shots. The whole mansion was filled with death grins. "I pushed the guards away from me and ran downstairs with fear. What if Jungkook or his guards shoot my dad? But when I arrived, I froze in my spot. There were a lot of injured guards, and every inch was covered in blood. And the furniture was broken and glasses shattered everywhere." Jungkook was pointing a gun at my dad. "Among them, my dad's shirt was stained with blood, helpless in Jungkook's power." "Jungkook, stop it!" Everyone looked at her. "Princess, are you alright?" he asked her. She ran to them, pushed Jungkook away from her head, and hugged him, crying. Her dad also hugged her back emotionally. "I came, princess, I came." He reassured her and kissed her on forehead. She looked back at Jungkook with burning eyes. "I have never seen the voice of beast than you. You said a few months ago you would marry me and apologize. But now you are ready to kill my dad." "What?" Jimin asked her, dropping the gun in disbelief. Then Jungkook nodded to Jimin and looked at her guilty. "It was a gun war. Try to understand. Even though your father is my enemy, not a kind person, so I had to defend myself when he engaged in war." "What harm has my dad done to your family?" "Your dad joined my father's gang under ordinary circumstances. However, he later betrayed my father by stealing his weapons to hand them over to Jack. Your dad backstabbed my father and even shook hands with Jack. But my father managed to escape cleverly just before your father and Jack could kill him." Wan looked at her dad with a look of disdain, which her dad couldn't bear. He lowered his head in shame and spoke. "Yes, I betrayed Mr. John because I wanted to become a mafia man and billionaire instead of remaining just a god in John's gang. But I never wanted to kill Mr. John for my own desires. But Jack tried to kill. For my sins, I was afraid that your father might harm me. So I held my daughter, thinking that even if he tried to kill me or destroy me, he could only kill me. But when I found out he had died, I cried so much with guilt. Please forgive me, John." "No, I'll never forgive you. Because of you, my dad suffered a lot. Lost everything in his life, and in the end, he became sick and dead in the hospital. If you want, I'll give whatever I had gained from him, and I will even leave this mafia for you. But please don't involve my daughter in what I have done." Mr. Kim was still scared that Jungkook might use Wan without knowing Jungkook still can hurt Wan. Then Jimin came between them, patted on Jungkook's shoulder, making his look at him once with concern. "Our father is also not alive, and we can't get anything back from Mr. Spooky. Let's take whatever he earned. Every single penny after beating our father. Try to find a place in your heart to forgive him. He can't change anything now. How can you say that, Jimmy? Oh wait, how can you defend me too? When my dad adopted you? Jimmy was haunted by Jungkook's sad voice. His eyes glittering with tears. Jungkook, stop it. I'm always by your side. Don't bring up this matter again. Sorry. Jungkook felt guilty and nodded. There was only silence. Then Brian spoke. Jungkook, you want me to forgive you, right? He nodded. What will I get if I forgive you? Whatever you want. Really? I'm a man of my word. Okay, I'm forgiving you, and you forgive my dad too. Jungkook was happy that he finally forgave him, but the next words made his happiness vanish. What? Don't go back on your words, Jungkook. I forgive you, Mr. Kim. Mr. Kim felt relieved, but he was shocked when he heard what Ryan said next, before he could fully feel happiness. Dad, you beat his father years ago. Because of you, he lost his property and his health. And now, it's time for justice. She looked at Jungkook with concerned expression. Jungkook, you can take legal actions against Mr. Kim. I think you have just gathered all the evidence of his betrayal. And you will see him in court. He will repay every penny of what he stole from your father. And he will face the consequences of his actions. She looked at her dad with jaded eyes. I love you so much, Dad. What you have done is not a small mistake to forgive. Mr. Kim's eyes welled up with tears, but he nodded kindly to me. I understand, Princess. I'll do whatever you say to me. Here, it's all clear. I mean, Wang, please don't leave. I want you. I'll marry you. I love you. Don't say you love me one more time, because it's just an obsession. Even if it's love, I don't accept your love. I just don't want you, Jungkook. We have no connection to each other here. You hurt me so much. Abused me too. I know you are regretting it too, but I can't marry you after all this. Like it's nothing. Forget about me. Jungkook came closer to her, holding her both of her hands, his eyes falling with tears as he cried badly. Please, Fine, try to understand my feelings. Please, I won't let you go. Never. Jungkook, clean me. He was crying, shaking his head. Mr. Kim felt sad for Jungkook, and Jimin's eyes were already filled with tears. Since I was born, I have been living my life as my dad desired. I had to live in the mansion and not step in, and not you. You are trying to emotionally make me melt with your tears. Don't you guys let me live as I want? I want to live as I want. Let me go. If you still cry, I will sympathize with you maybe, but I definitely won't develop feelings for you. If you respect my opinion, then just let me live my life as I want. Jungkook let go of her hands immediately and even stepped back away from her. I won't force you. If you want to leave, okay, I will leave you. I will respect your will, Wang, he said while sobbing. She gave a painful smile to them and left from there.